the best gift that I've ever known. You give me purpose. Yeah, you've given me purpose.
Hi everyone, it's me, Natasha Lampkin from Tasha Inc. I'm back with Reading with a Purpose, and today's feature is Second Chances by Alison Stanley. And here with me are my lovely friends so we can talk about this book.
Hi everyone, my name is Sabine, and I totally enjoyed Second Chances by Alison. She definitely did a great job expressing how two best friends could be happy for each other, but yeah, at the same time, also have second chances at love.
Hi everyone, I'm Soraya. I enjoyed reading Second Chances. It was a really inspiring book and great read.
Hi, my name is Jessica. I had a good time reading the book. I couldn't put it down. Can't wait for your next book. Thanks.
Yes, I thought the book was juicy, but definitely inspiring, and I learned a lot from the book. So, good job, Alison. Okay, ladies, let's start talking. All right. So, overall, I thought this book was really good. Not only was it a page turner, I learned a lot because I related with the characters, especially Rachel. I don't know who you felt like you mostly related to, but just let me know.
I think we all related to the single one.
Yeah.
Because none of us are engaged, but I mean, that's a good, she's still a good read because we will be there one day. And it kind of will, like, show us, you know, just make sure you don't hold any secrets back, you know, when you do meet that next person.
Yeah.
But I think we, like, can also be related to the single one.
Yeah.
Looking for love, still.
Yeah, but she was definitely back and forth with, like, the thing about Rachel, she was so into Nate's appearance. And that is my issue in the beginning when I first start, you know, talking to somebody. I see, you know, the parents first. And with Steven, she felt like he was, like, too short. He wasn't that athletic. And that's why she really wasn't attracted to him fully, even though he was a good guy. And that's the story of my life. You know, I'm not attracted to the ones, you know, who are supposedly good guys, I'm not attracted to them right away, you know, and that is my issue. So I feel like with Hannah, she was more so like, you know, she had a good thing, but, you know, she wanted to test the waters, you know, she fell into temptation. So I don't know if you guys have ever been in a relationship where you just felt like, you know, you had a good thing, but somebody else came around, even though you know that person is not the one for you, but you still were tempted to, talk to them a certain way.
I think we all do fall into that maybe temptation, but I feel like she was kind of young still. I think they were 22. Mm-hmm. I think she was 22. I think she was still kind of young. I mean, God will bring your soulmate to you, you know, whenever. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, I guess the age doesn't really matter, but to fall into that temptation, she was still pretty young, and she still kind of needed to live life and maybe date more, experience more, to realize what a good guy is
and how he should treat us. Why is it that we always fall for the bad guy?
I don't know. It's like...
What is it about Nate that, you know, makes Rachel so into him, and yet when it comes to Steven, you know, she kind of puts him on the back burner, and it's until he helps her out with her car that she's like, oh, he's so dreamy.
Yeah.
I think it's attraction. Like, I mean, everyone, men and women, initially, you look at someone and you're physically attracted to them or not. And if you're, like, you know, you want to be with someone that you're attracted to. We don't, I guess, think about once we get to know people, you know, then we'll find traits about them that are attractive, but we're so drawn to their personality. We're not thinking about that. First, we're just like, oh, he's cute. No, he's not that cute. No, he's not my type.
Yeah.
I think it's, we all just fall into that. It's just, like, hard to kind of break.
A lot of times, I think that we we also are attracted to the mystery in that, I guess, bad boy image. So, the good guy, we tend to feel like we know all about them already. Oh, they're going to be this great person and so forth. That's boring to us.
Right.
Where we want that mystery. Or we also feel like that bad boy is the type of guy that will beat anyone up for us or protect us in a way. So when she saw that Steven was showing qualities that he's a protector and he saved her and rescued her multiple times in different situations, she started to see that he is also a protector, even though he's the good guy or the nerdy guy.
Yeah. So that attracted her to him, because I can say this from my point of view, I'm all about strength. So when a guy shows me strength, and it doesn't have to be physical, but it could be like mentally or emotionally, it's attractive. So with Steven, he showed her a type of strength that she hasn't seen in him before, you know? And every woman, I believe every woman, they want their significant other to feel like, they want to feel like they're protected by their significant other, you know? So I guess when she saw Steven and what he did for her, she just realized, like, he's a different type of guy. You know, he's not like this nerdy guy that she assumed that he was, you know, who majored in computer science. She just thought, like, wow, like, you know, I misunderstood him. You know, I didn't get to know him more. And a good thing God gave her a second chance. That's how I feel. And I felt like sometimes that happens where, you know, you can date somebody, but God didn't tell you to be with that person. Like, you can be like a vessel where you just bring that person to God and like, you know, just help them out with their walk, because that's what she did with Nate. And, you know, Nate, he found Aaron, and Aaron found Jesus. So, yeah. I think every relationship, it's a reason for the relationship, you know? So, and I've been through situations where, you know, I dated somebody who was that guy, wasn't right, but eventually I found out that he wasn't right, you know? And the good guy, he was a back burner, but, you know, he moved on. So, yeah, it happens sometimes. It happens.
Yeah, I definitely feel that when you have that relationship with God, God will reveal things to you as people in due time.
Mm-hmm.
So I really liked how Rachel and Hannah would have conversations with God within the book and mm-hmm. ask for God's guidance and just letting them know what the right decisions to make and so forth. So that was really nice. They were seeking God's wisdom to help them choose and make right decisions in their life. And even Hannah at one point realized that she kind of neglected God at a point when she was so distraught over what happened between her and Tim. She realized that that she was neglecting God, and she took the time to go to God in prayer and really seek guidance, which is sometimes what I believe us as women, we forget to do, that God... Rachel said that God is our first true love, so sometimes we forget to really counsel with God first before we say that a man is for us, or this is what God wants us, or we're seeing this guy and he's supposed to be ours.
Yeah, that's true.
Seeking God first.
Yeah, I think I learned, I think for me what I learned is definitely the best thing is to talk to God first. Before, in the past, years ago, I never did that. And I always end up making the wrong decision. But now, ever since I did that, you know, things is easier for me. Like, okay, I see the signs. Know how this is going to go. I already see the whole setup. And, you know, when God sends me a scripture about someone, I can then decipher to see, like, okay, yeah, he's not right. Or, you know, maybe I should give him a chance, because I think God wants me to be his friend for a reason, and eventually I end up finding out why. So, you know, That's how it is. I don't know what have you learned? What have you learned from this?
Well, I've definitely learned for once that the good guy, it's okay to date the good guy. And, you know, sometimes, like I said, like in the book, sometimes you can be used as a vessel to help another person, help another person's relationship with God to get a lot stronger. But at the same time, it's just always good to, you know, hopefully you have that second chance, but if you don't, just know that maybe it's not so bad to give the good guy a chance at love.
Mm-hmm. It's true.
I think also when she made a point, like, you know, every time she goes somewhere, it's like, oh, am I going to find my husband here? Am I going to find my husband here? And to stop doing that, you know, just live life.
Yeah.
You know, not everywhere you go, like, oh, he's cute. You know, he's going to be my man. He's going to be my husband. So, you know, just live life. And, you know, like, you know, we all said, seek God's counsel. And, you know, these things will happen. You know, you don't just have to go everywhere thinking, oh, my husband's going to be here, or waiting, or wanting. Just live life. And it'll happen.
Can we be honest? Like, don't tell me you guys haven't thought that. Like,
yeah.
Back in my mind all
like,
the
oh,
time.
Even
recently with me, I'm like, I go, there's this place, there's my husband here. Like, I don't know what it is. Even though I'm busy, you know, I'm doing my own thing, I don't know why that thought keeps popping up in my head. Like, ooh, like, he's cute. Like, he could be
somebody I'm going to. Yeah, it's something we really, like, I try to pray for a lot. Like, you know, just live life. I go to these places thinking these things and nothing ever happens, ever.
It usually happens when you least expect it.
Yeah. So it's just
I don't know what God has to do for me. Like, knock me over the head so I won't think like that anymore because it's hard for me. All right, let me pray.
Pray
I need to pray because like, what's wrong with me? It's not as bad as it was before, but...
It's not only you. It's
just
a lot of...
But
the book, I'm glad that the book, you know, touched on that
it
and
did.
Pointed it out because it's not only us, it's also everyone else in the world.
Exactly. Which it felt like I felt so comforted just reading that part, you know, like, yes, like she's not the only one. She goes through the same thing I'm going through.
Yes, it was very relatable.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But Hannah, I'm just like, girl, you just need to just keep your man. Stop looking for other,
because
he's good. That's a good man. Like, you know?
You know what I didn't get? I don't know. What exactly did her and the doctor do?
They kissed. And
if
they were fondling each other, but they didn't go... They didn't go all the way. I don't know. They didn't really
go
in deep in the
story. Upset because she kissed him?
No.
They were,
I think
no,
it was more
but
than
there
kissing.
There was more than kissing.
It was more
than kissing. More like fondling and stuff like that, but they didn't go...
But it was
know.
Before him.
No.
Yes.
It was before him. Oh, yeah, she
so
didn't
why,
say anything.
Why was he so upset?
That was 5 years ago.
Oh, yeah, it was
right.
5 years ago. Yeah, you're right.
He was upset because he thought she was pure.
Did he think she never kissed a guy before? Or, like...
Well, certain Christians, they don't believe in kissing before you get married.
So I'm assuming maybe she told him that? She's never
so she
never...
didn't really keep it real with him 100%. So, and when I read that part, I was like, wow. Part, I'm like, that's a good guy.
Yeah.
You know, like, because some guys, they wouldn't even care. They're like, okay, kissing. And these are Christian men, you know, or Christian women. They wouldn't think that's a big deal. Like, okay. But you see, we can't think like that. There's a reason why, you know, we're not supposed to get that intimate with somebody that's not our life partner. You know, God wants us to be pure for our significant others for a reason. So that's what the book, it highlighted on. And it made me appreciate my celibacy even more because I know whenever I started dating, I'm going to really keep a lot of things in mind, a lot of things that I learned in my walk. So I don't know. Do you guys have any highlights? Like anything that stood out to you, like a best, your favorite part in the book?
My favorite part, I guess it was the lesson I was going to tie into what you guys had said, was when her dad came to speak to her in the bedroom and really kind of gave his perspective that your plans doesn't align, it may not align with God's plans, so we have to be okay with that.
where I believe he injured himself and he was taken out of his tennis career. Mm-hmm. So in his eyes, he thought he was going to be this great tennis star, but he still felt unfulfilled in what he was doing. But God's plan for him was something else. And whatever God's plan was for him, he felt 100 times more fulfilled in it. And although we have our own plans of who we're going to be with or what our career goals are, we may never end up being truly fulfilled unless that's God's plan for us. So that was a nice lesson to see and just for the conversation we had with Dad.
Yeah, I love that. I know for me, my favorite part was when Stephen approached Rachel to have that dance.
Yeah.
And I was like, yes. You know, she had a second chance. And they got together. That was my favorite part in the book. Because I was like, oh, you know, so sad. Like, she,
poor Stephen.
You know, poor Stephen, poor her. You know, you know, but I really love that part in the book. You know, I'm hopeless romantic, so I really love that part.
I think the lesson learned also was just the amount of forgiveness that was going on. I mean, Stephen forgave Rachel for one, bringing Nate to the church right in front of his face.
Yeah.
But, you know, putting his arms over Rachel's shoulders and things of that sort and just blowing him off. And also for Tim, just forgiving Hannah for even, you know, keeping that secret from him. So it's really the amount of forgiveness that people can really have. And it's important that when you're able to forgive, there's a sense of relief that comes out of you as well.
That's true.
I also like that Rachel was so, I guess, also forgiving to Nate, letting him go. You know, they were already in a serious relationship at that point, and she was like, no, you should go. You know, and she was okay with it. You know, she knew that that's something that he needed to do, I guess, for himself. And also that Aaron really needed Nate. And also, I guess, to try to work on the family. Even though she really liked him, and this was like her dream guy, so to say, she let him go.
And Nate forgave
him. Yeah, and Nate forgave Aaron. So I like that.
Just forgiveness all around.
Yeah, that's what I love. I really love that. That the whole series of forgiveness and love, because it's true. It teaches us to... Like, forgiveness is everything. It's not for that person. It's for you. Because as soon as Rachel let go, when she let go of Nate, she and Stephen got together. You know? So, yeah. I agree. Yes. So, anything else you guys would like to add to the book? Overall?
Great pick, yeah.
I wanted to switch it up because, you know, something, you know, with fiction, you know, a short read, something that you can relate to, and I felt like that was a good pick.
So
I'm glad that you guys enjoyed. All right, so thank you. And the next book will be... 4 Things a Woman Wants from a Man by Pastor A.R. Bernard. Woo! Yes. Yeah, that's, you know, we all go to CCC.
Yes.
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 I know you're reading it right now.
I'm reading it right now.
I just started it.
Okay.
I haven't started yet.
Okay. Well, I know some guys who are reading it, so the next book club meeting, I'm going to try to get them in here so we can all discuss this book. Because I heard it's really good. And I have to start reading it myself. But
okay.
I can't wait.
Yes.
Thank you guys.
Thank you.
Whoa. Hi everyone. I'm your host, Natasha Lampkin, reading with the first. Sorry.
I let you in with all that I can. You're not hard to read. Gift that I've ever known. You give me purpose. Yeah, you've given me purpose. thinking my journey's come to an end. Oh, sending out a farewell to my friends. Far better peace, ask you to forgive me for my